Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about the calendar app and how it uses time zones. So here's a typical problem you run into. Say that you travel with your Mac and you go between time zones. Now to simulate this, I'm going to go into System Preferences under Date and Time, Time Zone, and I've turned off Set Time Zone automatically. And I'm going to change the time zone and make it East Coast time zone. So say I'm on the East Coast and I want to set up an appointment for Thursday. I add that appointment. I go in and I change it from all day and I'm going to set it for 3 p.m. Now this is an appointment for after I return home back to Mountain time zone. And if I look at it, it says 3 p.m. Great. Now I travel back to Mountain time zone and I look at the appointment again and I can see it changed it to 1 p.m. because it kept it at the same exact time. It's just that 3 p.m. on the East Coast is 1 p.m. Mountain Time. So if I was teleconferencing or something like that, it would kind of make sense. But in this case, I knew I wanted to go to this appointment at 3 o'clock when I got home. So changing the time on me was counterproductive. Matter of fact, it will really mess me up and I'll be there at the wrong time. So how can you fix this? Well, let's get rid of this event here and let's go into Calendar Preferences and under Advanced, let's turn on Time Zone Support. Now we have Time Zone here at the top and this is very useful if you travel because you can set the time zone for the calendar independent of the time zone for the system. So now if I go to the East Coast again in System Preferences, I set an event here and I change it so that it is 3 p.m. It's set for 3 p.m. now and it's set for Mountain Time because that's what the calendar is looking at. If I go and travel back to Mountain Time Zone and I look at the event again, you can see it hasn't changed because the time zone set Mountain Time. Matter of fact, it even confirms for this event that it's set for the time zone Mountain Time. Now let's say I wanted to set up an appointment for the next day and I'm still going to be on the East Coast. I'm going to set that for 2 p.m. and I want to set the time zone for that. Now I can select from time zones I've recently used or if it doesn't appear here. Like for instance, if I want it to be Central Time, I can just type in a city and it will appear and it will add it then to that list. So now I can see that that one appears here in the list with others. And when I hit done, it will set it up here. So it's 2 p.m. Central Time. So I know I'm going to be in the Central Time Zone on that day, so it makes sense. Now what would happen if I would change the time zone here at the top of calendar? So right now, for instance, I have this test here. It's going to be at 3 p.m. Mountain Time and I want to go and change it and say, you know what, I am right now in Eastern Time Zone. You can see now it keeps it there, 3 p.m. Mountain Time. And the same thing here, 2 p.m. Central Time. So it'll always go by this time zone, the time zone for the event, not the time zone at the top. But when I create a new event, you can see it's going to default here to Eastern Time Zone. So this really here at the top is a default setting. So if you move between coasts, you can use this to change back and forth so that you can change your default time zone and you can continue to adjust in each event which time zone it occurs in. Now you have another option. You can do something called a floating time. So let's do this test 4 here and let's set it up at 5 o'clock and let's instead of assigning a time zone we say floating. It's done. Now I'm setting this up in Eastern Time Zone. So this is going to basically give me the functionality of a moving time here. It's 5 o'clock p.m. and I'm going to change the default to Mountain Time and you can see now because I set the floating time it actually moved the time to 7 p.m. So this time will actually float, which is useful because for instance say if I want to set a reminder for 48 hours from now, if I set it to a specific time zone and I'm not in that time zone, it's not going to be exactly 48 hours. This will adjust as I adjust the time zone here at the top of calendar. There's a look at time zones and calendar. Now this is not something you can ignore at all if you travel between time zones and you use events because you're going to have events set to the wrong time unless you pay attention to the time zone and set it correctly for the event. Hope you found this useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. If you found this video useful, there's one thing you can do for me in return. It won't cost you anything and it will just take you a few seconds. If you're not already at MacMost.com, go there and then look for the video you just watched. Go to that page. Underneath the video, you'll see a bunch of different links that help you share the video with friends. Take a second to click the like button. This sends a signal out to the rest of the internet that the video is worth watching. Thanks.